Merci beaucoup. Pour le groupe socialiste et démocrate, Jutta Guteland.
Kommissionärskandidat Kyriakides. Exponering även av låga doser av hormonstörande ämnen kopplas till en rad mycket svåra sjukdomar som cancer, diabetes, svårigheter att få barn, infertilitet och missbildningar. Små barn är extra känsliga. Förutom mänskligt lidande så kostar det här skadorna också i Europa över 160 miljarder euro varje år. Det är inte längre möjligt för människor att undvika hormonstörande ämnen i sin vardag. De finns överallt, i leksaker, vårt vatten, kosmetika, matförpackningar. Alla har rätt till en vardag utan gifter. Jag vill därför veta om du kommer föreslå, utan ytterligare förseningar, horisontella kriterier för att identifiera hormonstörande ämnen i alla sektorer. Kan du lova här idag att du kommer agera konkret för att lösa detta allvarliga problem istället för att gömma dig bakom kommissionens svaga strategi från 2018 eller ytterligare löften om ännu en fitnesscheck? Tack.
Thank you. Well, first of all, I'd like to say that I'm a person that looks forward. So I will comment on what I would like to be doing now, from now on, Madame Guteland. And I will say, and I want to thank you for this question, because endocrine disruptors are in fact in my mission letter, which in itself shows that it is going to be a priority. And you're absolutely right that we need to do more, because they do impact on human health. We don't have any doubt about that now. I'm aware of the European Parliament resolution of 2019, and I'm also aware that the European Parliament wants to see legislation before 2020. We need to step up to define horizontal criteria, and I think this needs to be a priority. We have made progress in the last 20 years. I don't want to say that no progress has been made, but we need to do a lot more, because we know that we are here for one reason alone, at least as a designate commissioner for health, I'm here for one reason alone, and that is a commitment to protect citizens and the environment. There was something that I would want to add, if I may, to your question, is that we need more science to see the cocktail effects as well, which we are not aware of at the moment. So yes, I would look at waiting for the results of the fitness check to see how we can move forward. Already some member states are taking action plans on this. We need to support them. And I believe that we are all aware that endocrine disruptors are going to be a very important part of the agenda of the next commission.
Tack för det svaret. Jag ska inte argumentera med det här idag, men jag vill ha ytterligare ett förtydligande. Håller du med om att hormonstörande ämnen är en fara som är lika oroande som cancerogena, mutagena och reprotoxiska ämnen? Om du är redo då att i en sektorsöverskridande definition av hormonstörande ämnen föreslå en distinktion mellan kända, förmodade och misstänkta hormonstörande ämnen som redan finns i EU:s lagstiftning när det gäller just cancerogena, mutagena och reprotoxiska ämnen?
I definitely wouldn't want to have an argument with you about anything. What I would like to have is the chance to have the opportunity to discuss with you and hear from you to take in all these concerns. And that is why I said I would be available. I wouldn't compare whether endocrine disruptors are as dangerous as cancer. I know that they impact on human health, and I know that we need to do something about it. And this is going to be my commitment to taking this up. We're waiting for the fitness check. I would look forward to working with you, to seeing what we need to do to move forward, because it is definitely not an area that we can afford to leave behind. And I'm clear on that.